क्या फर्क है, खा लो।
Okay. So, good morning and welcome to what we are calling as Orkla Ehs Week. Okay, so this was recognized and, you know, celebrated or done across all companies in the last week. Okay, and given that we had Dashan and other functions clashing with this event, we actually pushed it by 1 week to this week, that is 22nd to 27th of October. Now, EHS, I'm not very sure how many of you actually know what these three words mean, but it's a fairly familiar word for a lot of us at the senior management levels and people who have interacted with this. So let me first start by asking some of you, what do you understand by the three letters EHS? Okay, and I'm going to start not with the people at the GM and above level, but I'm going to start with the people at heads and below level who are out here. Okay, so all heads and below, what do the words EHS mean to you? Let's start with, what does the letter E stand for?
Environment.
Okay, environment. Now, when that's environment. What is H?
Health.
Okay. And what is S?
Safety.
Okay. You certainly know the meanings of, the expansions of each of these letters, and that is. But how many of us are truly aware? You know, aware is not just knowing what these three words are. How many of us truly are aware of what this is, and how many of us interface with these things? Okay? What I want you to do today, and this session is just about introduction of EHS to you, what I want to do today with you guys is to help you engage with these three words, environment, health, and safety. Okay? And when I say engage, I want you to think about these three words at two levels. The first level I want you to think about it is from the company level. How does the company impact environment, health, and safety? Okay? And the second level I want you to think about is, how do you as an individual interface with environment, health, and safety? Okay? So let's take the word environment. Okay? And let's talk about, and this is going to be a interactive session with you. So let's talk about how does the company and you interface with the environment. Okay? Anyone? Wastage that you generate. What kind of wastage? Production output wastages. So there are two kinds of wastages that we generate in production. One is biodegradable wastages. That has minimum impact on the environment. The second is wastages that are non-biodegradable. Do they impact us? How does that impact the environment? It degrades slowly. So it's a waste. We have to do garbage management steps, and we often find that these are not done in our country. Okay, as an individual, how do you impact the environment? I don't want GMs and above to speak. Okay, I want other people to speak. The silent people of MTR to speak. Okay, so I'm going to start talking to this row. This row and behind, and this row and behind, excepting you, okay, and you too, okay. So let's talk about it. How do you, as an individual, impact the environment?
Avoid plastics, carry bags.
Why? So how does it harm the environment? Give me. Correct. What other ways do we impact the environment? Is environment just garbage?
Smoke from the
moment you ride our cars, we create and generate air. The more diesel and petrol that we use, we are creating air pollution. Okay? And there are laws that help you reduce the impact on air pollution, which is by other things that you, any other way that you impact environment is about garbage, environment is about air pollution. What else is environment about?
Noise
pollution. How do we reduce noise? How do we impact noise pollution?
Blowing horn
is one thing. Yes. Any other way? Loudspeakers. Okay. What other way? What are the other pollutions that we have? Water pollution. How do we pollute water? Do we have indefinite supply of water? Okay. So how do we create water pollution? By use of water. I don't want one person to keep answering, okay? There are others out here. So I want you to start waking up and start giving me answers. Otherwise, I'll go pointed. Okay? Abhi democracy hai, then I'll become autocratic. Huh? So water pollution. Give me examples of water pollution. Washing clothes is water, generating water pollution. You dirty the water goes into the drains, and then is it fit for use?
Industrial washing clothes and industrial, as a corporate, we use water. We wash our machines and we use toilets where we generate and impact water. So water pollution is impacted out there. Any other ways? Dispose waste in water. Yeah, so we often quite often throw plastics all over the place, and we've had incidences of fishes, when they have been cut open, have plastics in them. Okay? And would you like to eat that kind of a fish? So it starts to impact your food. Okay? It'll go into our farm. It'll leach into the farm soils, and that's how you'll start impacting the environment around it. So environment is very important for us. Okay? Quite often, we don't carry it as a issue at the top of our heads. Okay? And we don't, because we just keep living life and we say, hopefully someone else will take care of this problem. Okay? The second word using is health. Health important from a perspective. First, let's talk from a corporate perspective. Impacts productivity. How? Absenteeism will go up. So if you're not healthy, you're going to take more leave. And although they are your, as they say, but we don't want you to take those earned leave. We want you to be healthy, okay? So be more productive during a day. Health. Quality of life, your productivity as a person goes up if you are healthy, okay? So these are dimensions of health for a corporate. What are the dimensions of health as an individual? Quite similar. Are you concerned about your health? Anyone? Let me just tell you one thing. You can be the best employee for MTR. The best, the most contributing, the most productive employee for MTR. But if you are not healthy, you are useless to MTR. Allow me to tell you are useless to MTR. Because we don't know which day what will happen to you and you will stop coming to work. Can a company rely on such a resource which is not healthy? Okay, so whose onus is to ensure that we take care of our health? We heard of sayings like health is wealth, right? Is it really wealth? Do you really understand it's your wealth? Or do you only understand it till the day you fall sick, or till the day you start to get one or the other lifestyle disease, okay, like a blood pressure, or diabetes, or cardiovascular disease. And for you as an individual, if you have better health, you will be more productive. And if you are more productive, you will grow, you will earn more, you will have a better quality life and lifestyle in your living days. All of us are going to grow old. All of us are going to die. Okay? But we certainly don't want any of those things to happen. As long as you are young, and you have the capability to become healthy and fit. Okay? So health is a very, very important dimension. The third word that we talk about in this is safety. From a company point of view, what is important? Why is safety important? Providing a safe workplace for workers. What do you mean by that? So they should know how to use the equipment. And if there's a calamity, they should know how to stop it. So like we've had fire instances in our factories, and if we had not given safety equipment available. So our first is providing safety equipment to our employees. So if you're dealing with something hot, do you have gloves? If you're dealing with something heavy, over 5 kilos, do you have vacuum pickers so that you can lift heavy bags? If you're doing a 10 kilo bag lift 30 times a day, can you imagine the kind of impact that will have on your muscular system? Okay, so as a company, it is our responsibility to ensure that we build supports safety. Okay, that is why in this building we have a fire alarm system. Okay, so if there is a fire, then we should be able to take quick actions to evacuate the building. Okay, in our machines we try and ensure that there is safety. I remember when I joined, we had pounding machines and there was no safety barrier out there, and people were putting their hands in and turning the masala over. And over a period of time, we've worked with those machines and we've improved the safety standards of those machines. Okay? And that is the responsibility of a company, to ensure that we have good, safe work environment given to our people. In the pounding section, again, and many parts of our factories, the noise level in the factory is very high. We have to give them safety equipments like headphones or noise phones to people, because if you are exposed to high levels of high pitched sounds, then it's going to impact your hearing. Okay, or if you are in a dusty environment in a factory like what is there in our masala factory, that is why we wear, you know, masks when we go to the factory. You will find that we don't want to be breathing too much of dust into our lungs. It can cause you respiratory diseases, and all of that will start to impact the health of the employees and therefore impact productivity and so on and so forth. So these three words, environment, health and safety, are very, very important and critical to our, and it is important. One more dimension I want to touch upon from a safety. Okay, how is it important for an individual to be conscious of safety? And how are we not conscious of it? Anyone?
Wearing helmets.
How many times the laws of the land suggest that the driver and the pillion must wear helmets? How many times do we not wear helmets? How many times do we think it like this? Oh, I'm just going down the road. Let me not wear a helmet and go. How many of us have done that? Many of us have done that. Okay? Wearing helmets, if it is a law, it is for you. If it is wearing seat belts in a car is a law, it is for you. It is for your safety. How many of y'all heard about the Amritsar incident? Huh? The train came and mowed down 50 people. We can debate on the 10s and 15s. Okay. But the point is, what you should miss is, there were many people standing on the railway track and watching Dashara. Who was wrong in this? The people or the train driver? Really? What is the media telling us? What is the politicians telling us? Huh? What are we thinking in India? What do we think? We've got 1.3 billion people. We can kill hundreds of them. Okay, chalo. No problems. Hundreds are disposable as long as it's not me. You know, intrinsically in India, we are taught to be unsafe. Okay? And that percolates into the most educated person in every company. What will happen to you if you meet with an accident? Will you be able to come to office? will accidents happen only when we are going for a 1 hour ride? Will accidents happen when you are going for a 10 minute or a 2 minute ride? Can we think about these things? You know, we are just not taught to be safe. It's not in our blood. And I don't know why. Because it's all for us. It's all for our personal safety. So these three words are very, very important words. And at MTR. And what we are trying to do today is to make hours of your time on this subject. Okay? And we will talk to you about this to help you raise awareness. Okay? We will tell you what are the ways that you can ensure that you take care of these three things. Okay? Environment, health, and safety, not only for the company, but at a personal level also. Okay? And then we will all, at the end of this, sign a commitment towards it. But that is only half the job done. Okay? As I always say, and I love to use this phrase, I can take the horse to the water, but I cannot make you drink the water. Committing to the environment, committing to health, your health, and committing to your safety is important for you. I can tell you that, but I can't make you do this. Okay? So you guys have to be evoked within yourself. You need to realize it within yourself to understand that, do you want to be conscious of the environment? Do you know that Cape Town in South Africa, okay, was to experience what they call is the zero on April of 2000. They got to know 1 year before that. You know what 0 day is? Where there is no water. Okay? And then they started to institute measures of rationing water. So I know of people who had gone to South Africa and they said that they were rationed. When they checked into the hotel, for two people they were told, you will get only 30 liters of water. Okay? Per day. And the entire community got into it and got into saving water. Now the day zero has been moved off to 2019, I think. But do you know what is the day zero for Bangalore city? Sorry? No, it's not yet here. We just keep praying to the gods for rains and then hopefully the day zero goes off. But there is going to be a day zero for Bangalore. And Bangalore is amongst the top 10 cities in the world that is going to experience a day zero before 2025. Okay? Which means that Bangalore city will not have water. Can you imagine your life without water? Can you just imagine? Someone gives you 10 liters of water per day as your quota as an individual. Can you live within that? You will drink 2 liters at least. Or you're supposed to drink 2 liters. You have to take a bath, your daily ablutions, wash your bartans. Will you wash your car with a hose pipe that day? Let me wash my car today. Or my bike. Think about what actions we do and how indiscriminately we use our natural resources and we come to doing things. So environment is very important and so is health and your safety. Okay? So we're going to be spending a week around this at MTR and hopefully people will get in touch with you one or two more times during the week to evoke awareness around this thing. So what are we going to do? The objective of the week is to make our company and hopefully have some impact on you as individuals to make Orkla a safe and a healthy workplace with the spirit of one Orkla. Okay? We want to be a responsible, we want to make our company a safe and a healthy place to work. We want to prevent injuries, illnesses, to support the journey towards zero harm. Okay? The idea is to have zero. We have accidents within the company, and today the level is what? About 7? 0.36 per million man hours is the level of accidents in MTR. We are amongst the best in class as far as Orkla is concerned. Our objective is to hit zero. Okay? This week, what we will try and do is to imbibe the EHS culture and the next steps on Orkla's journey towards zero harm in a healthy workplace, to have common activities across Orkla organizations, to get inspired by sharing experience with each other and different companies. All Orkla locations will work on a few simple mandatory EHS topics, and optional EHS topics will be chosen by different factories. Okay? So this is what we are going to do, and that is why all of you all have been gathered here today. The same program is being done amongst all our workers in the factory. So Ankur is out there conducting the same presentation, and out there the level of intensity of the program is much, much higher than what it is going to be at corporate office. But before we go into more details of the presentation, let me share with you the a quick video about with Peter Rusicka actually telling us what EHS means and why this is important for us. So over to Peter Rusicka.
Hello everybody. To me, environment, health and safety is about taking care of all Orkla employees so they every day can go home safe and unharmed. I expect Orkla leaders to make their contribution in establishing a sound EHS culture and to take part in the ongoing work to eliminate accidents, secure a healthy workplace and minimize the environmental impact from our activities. We need to be trustworthy and establish an injury-free and healthy workplace. We must also inspire our employees to take active part in driving a sound EHS culture. And we must be brave enough to take the actions needed, and we must tell our employees to always do their job in a safe and responsible way. By working as one Orkla, sharing knowledge and best practice, I believe that we will strengthen the EHS performance towards the vision of zero harm. Hello everybody. To me, environment, health and safety is about taking care of all Orkla employees, so they every day can go home safe and unharmed. I expect Orkla leaders to make their contribution in establishing.
And these rules will ensure that we will become more aware of what the issues and challenges of EHS are and how can we be a positive contributor to these three words. Okay? So the aim of the golden rules is to prevent severe injuries, illnesses, incidents and support the journey towards zero harm. Now what we have learned while doing all this is that people move from level 1 to level 4 in terms of anything actually. Okay? The first level is a reactive level. You have a problem, you take a medicine for it. You fall ill, you go to a doctor, you take a medicine. That's called reactiveness. Okay? So you have an injury, we go to the machine and we look at it, the machine, and say, okay, why the injury happened, what are the problem, let us fix the problem. That's being reactive. Once the thing has been solved, we forget everything and we go back to regular life. Okay, so we don't think about, arey flu hi to hua tha, kya jata hai? Okay, yeah, थोड़ा सा ब्रेथलेसनेस हुई थी, क्या जाता है, लेट्स कैरी ऑन विद लाइफ, ओके, एंड दैट्स हाउ वी टेंड टू लिव. द सेकेंड लेवल इज दैट वी बिकम कंप्लायंट पीपल. सो मेनी टाइम्स व्हेन वी आर रिएक्टिव, व्हेन वी स्टार्ट टू से ये रूल है मेरे को कंप्लाई करने का, ओके, समवेयर आउट देयर देयर इज अ कंपनी और समवन हु इज सेइंग इफ यू मेक अ मिस्टेक, इफ यू हैव एन इंजरी, instead of while we will sympathize with you and while we will take care of you, we will also caution you, and if you continue to do this, we will classify you as an unsafe employee and we will take action against you, okay. That is when what we think is compliance thinking. So I am a compliance person, I have 10 rules, I follow the 10 rules very well, okay. The third level of thinking is responsible thinking. Okay, in responsible reaction, you are still being compliant, but you are being a little bit more compliant. You are being responsible towards those particular situations only. Okay, so you think about starting a machine, you think about it, in you think, okay, I am responsible for it, so mere area mein issue nahi hona chahiye. So I am only concerned with my area, my responsibility. And I take care of environment, health and safety from those perspectives. The fourth area is the area where we want everyone to reach, is what we call as internalization. Okay, this part needs to come from within you. This is the attitude or the behavior or the set of the way you think is what we want you to develop inside you. And in this kind of a situation, it doesn't make a difference whether you are responsible or not responsible for a particular thing. But if you see it happening anywhere in the company or with anyone, you feel it your own responsibility to ensure that you raise the issue. Okay? So most people and most companies move from reactive to and move towards internalization. Okay, so if you ask me, our factory is somewhere here, somewhere between reactive and compliant, and at corporate office we are here, we are at a reactive level, okay, because till the time we don't raise the issue up with you, you will not react to solving the problem. So I'll come across one day in the finance department and say, yaar bada gand macha hai yaar, Ganesh kuch karo, Jayant जरा देखो यार क्या गंद मचा हुआ, क्या तुमने फाइलें वाइलें रखी हुई है, देन पीपल रिएक्ट, देन वन डे द एंटायर डिपार्टमेंट विल बिकम क्लीन. आई एम नॉट जस्ट पिकिंग ऑन फाइनेंस, डोंट, बट इट इज देयर विद मार्केटिंग एज वेल, एंड आई डोंट कम टू मच टू द थर्ड फ्लोर, बट आई एम श्योर इट इज हियर एज वेल, ओके. सो देन पीपल रिएक्ट, देन दे विल क्लीन अप. आर यू क्लीनिंग अप फॉर मी? Are you cleaning up for someone who is visiting our office? Or are you cleaning up for yourself? Okay? So, we have to move from reactive to internalizing some of these things. We should do it because we feel good about it. Okay? Because we feel that this is the way of life that I want to lead. I want to wear a helmet because it is safe for me. I don't want to wear a helmet because the CEO saw me or Mr. Barua saw or some Mancom member saw and told me about that. I want to wear a helmet because I want to be safe. Right? So that is where this is. So the aim of the golden rule is to really prevent illnesses, injuries. So when we did yoga classes, 15 people joined, 8 people remained. Including I dropped out. So I will stand up for that before someone tells me. 15 people came in because they were interested. They actually came out of here. They came out of internalization. I need to do yoga because it's good for health. Uske baad usne aisi bajayi, ki people had all kinds of pains and decided to drop off. Then the excuses started. घर में बहुत काम है यार, आई नीड टू गो होम, इट टेक्स वन आवर फॉर मी टू गो होम, So excuses are there plenty. I do my exercises at home. No one is there to check. You got something.
Yeah. Give me, I'll put.
Hello, you got me? Hello. Okay, that's better. So, you know, we have to move down the scale, and the objective is zero harm. How can I be proactive towards causing zero illnesses? Everyone knows if you exercise daily, you'll never fall sick, yeah, because your body is generating more white blood cells that will help you take care of your all the germs that are coming inside your body. But how many of us exercise daily? We are worried about how I look, main mota ho gaya, meri tond aa gayi, but we are not worried about our health. Am I fit? Okay, so these are some of the things that we need to move towards. Okay, the golden rules are also based on experiences and incidents are from Orkla. Okay, they also reflect applicable legal and regulatory requirements, because every time there's an accident in the factory, we have to report it to the authorities, and then we come under a scanner of the authorities that are we a safe working place or are we not a safe working place. Okay, golden rules also reinforce critical aspects covered in the Orkla EHS requirements. And these must be adhered by all employees at all times. Okay, so we will try and circulate this to all employees so that they are aware of it and they know this. So what are the golden rules? These are the basic EHS rules for every Orkla employee. They basically take care of three things. They care for people, and the environment must be, and we have to be a good role model for that. We have to act when you observe the risk and contribute to the EHS improvements. Okay? So we cannot be passive in this. We have to be active employees. You see something happening, we expect you to respond. It is not about squealing on another employee. Okay? But it is acting in the interest of the company. So if you see something go wrong, then tell us. We will work towards improving that particular aspect within our company. And the third thing is, we need to take time to carry out activities in a safe and a responsible manner. So when we do activities, we must think before we do. Okay? So what, we'll come to the seven rules that are called the golden rules. The first golden rule is that we commit to behavior. Okay, we understand that injuries and serious incidences can be prevented through our behavior and actions. Okay, basic principles are show engagement, be a good role model. So be engaged. Quite often when we do an activity, someone tells us, ye pada hai bhari 20 kilo ka sack, isko udhar rakhwa de yaar stores mein. Then we say, acha main bhejta hu kisi ko. तब तक कौन रुकेगा, चलो मैं ही उठा के ले जाके जाता हूँ. ओके, आई विल पिक इट अप एंड टेक इट. वी डोंट थिंक, वी आर एक्टिंग क्वाइट ऑफन. एंड दिस इज अगेन अ वेरी वेल नोन ट्रेट, इज दैट वी आर मोर ट्रेन्ड एज पीपल टू एक्ट देन टू थिंक. ओके, हियर व्हाट वी आर आस्किंग यू टू डू इज टू सर्टनली थिंक बिफोर यू एक्ट. Okay, be a good, show engagement, be a good role model, follow rules, stay alert. What rules are there? The rules are there for yourself. They are not there for anyone else. Contribute towards EHS improvement. You see something wrong in the company, you tell us. You tell your boss, you tell your boss's boss, you tell it to the biggest guy, and you, if you want, tell it to Orkla, to, that we need to improve. Take responsibility for your own safety. Your You are responsible for your own safety and no one else. So you take decisions which are wrong, you will face the consequences of that. care for the safety of your colleagues and others. So if you see your colleague practicing an unsafe act, ensure that you point it out to him. Okay? Ensure that you are fit and competent to work. Very important, as we've talked about fitness, and use the personal protective equipment which is used. So quite often we give you personal protective equipment, but you don't use it. Very often seen in factories, okay, where we've given them all a mask, they will put the mask and make it their dadi, and they will be sitting out there. Why? Sir, breathing mein problem hota hai. There'll be 10 excuses for every action that you take. But there will not be 10 reasons of why you should be following it. So, what personal protective equipments are given, please use them. Okay, they are for your safety and your health. Think before you act and ask if you don't know. Okay, that's the principle that you have to follow. The second golden rule is care for people. We understand that mutual respect and dignity are key to a healthy workplace. Okay? The principles are give recognitions and constructive feedback. Talk with your colleagues, not about them. Stop and say hello to co-workers. A smile is good enough if you can't say hello. And that's a great thing to do. Be polite. Be open. To people. If you don't like a person, you don't mind spending a smile on him also. Okay? Prevent and oppose harassment and bully. If there's anyone bullying or if someone harassing you, we have the posh policy in place. We have forums in place that will help you overcome some of this. Be respect and encourage diversity. Okay? We should encourage diversity. We are not just talking, we are an international company, so we just don't talk about foreigners versus Indians. But even in India, we have many people from many cultures now working with MTR. There are people from East, West, North, South. We must learn to respect them, accept them as they are, and accept their diversity and their differences. Our objective in this company is not to make everyone the same, but to accept the diversity which is there in the company. And we must be aware of work-life balance. And I keep saying this, and finance department is terrible at this, again. Working, how many of us, where is that guy? Working, still working late? So many of you all actually sit late and work so late. No one is asking you to work late. Be efficient, spend time. 8 hours is enough in a day to work hard. Go home, spend time with your family. Marketing is another big culprit to this. Be on time, go on time. You may be alone, you may be single. That doesn't mean that office is your bar and where you need to hobnob with people. No? You go out, yeah. There's Buck Buck Bar out here and so many more. Go and do the Buck Buck out there. But certainly in office, work hard, do your work, go home. We want you to go and spend time with your family. We want you to go and pursue recreational fun. Here's a lady who does motorcycle riding as a side hobby. She does take out time for it somehow. Working in the EHS department, yes, but so work-life balance in my mind is one of the most important things, okay? And I will tell you my own example. For the last 20 years, I have always tried to come from the morning till the evening. I finish my working hours, I finish my work and I go home. I never work at home. I don't encourage people to call me at home, okay? And you can still grow and do better and better in your life. So life is not about hard work, it's about intelligent work. So please spend time in terms of your work-life balance. That is a very important aspect. And I think we don't want to be a company where we enforce this. Okay?
take your leave. You get leave, take your leave. Go on a holiday. See the country, see the world, spend time with your family. It makes you richer as a person. Okay? So do that. Give support, share knowledge, and be a good colleague. Okay? So we expect you. Second is care for people, be a good colleague. Yeah? The third is reporting. We understand that reporting and investigating EHS incidents provides an important insight for preventing future incidents and continuous improvement. So the principles are report EHS incidents, unsafe conditions or act. If you find something which is unsafe or which is against the environment that the company is doing, please report it. Okay, and we will try and do something about it and improve it. Investigate to prevent reoccurrence. Learn from incidents without blaming. Okay, very easy to pass the buck. Very easy to point fingers. Help us solve the problem. Right? If you pass it, you accept it. You see something, you pass it, you accept it. That means you are part of the problem. So we want you to be proactive, we want you to be aware, we want you to contribute towards us becoming a better and a more compliant EHS company. Hashtag we commit to reporting. Okay? Third, the next is housekeeping. We understand that a clean and tidy workplace is essential to prevent injuries, equipment damages, and prevent discharges and pollution. Okay? In corporate office, cartons are meant to be kept inside the storerooms, not on the seat next to you, not on the table, not behind your chair, not under your chairs. Okay? Because somewhere someone will trip over it and fall. Do you want that incident to happen before you learn, or would you like to prevent that incident? Okay? And it's, you know, a clean place, everyone knows, motivates you to do better quality work. If you have challenges, raise it. We will try and address all of them. Keep your workplace clean and tidy. Use and maintain the tools and equipment to ensure a good working position. Report damaged equipment to get it fixed. Don't fix your own problems. Huh? Electricity point is not working. Main thoda tape maar deta hun do. MTR has a very good tape culture in the factory. Yeah? In factory, we see pipes with tapes around it. MTR ka cello tape. Problem tha, maine fix kar diya. Electricity point, tumhara work, in your working space, is there a problem? Don't try and fix it. You are not the genius electrical guy. If you get a shock, we will have a serious problem in office. Okay? So please do not take risks which you are not trained to do. Ensure that everything, damaged equipment is reported and people will respond to fix it. Clean up spills and wastages, think 5S, which is sort, set in order, shine, standardize and sustain. Okay? And the last principle, that overall ethic that we are trying to tell you, is care for your work area, leave it as you want it to be found. Would you like to come to a dirty office or would you like to come to a clean office? So we all want clean offices, so ensure that your desktops, working areas are all nice and clean. Machine safety. We understand that the correct operation, maintenance and cleaning of machinery can prevent injuries. And I was discussing with Bala, in corporate office, what machines do we have? So there we thought of Xerox machines. Huh? We think of printers. We have, in some places, we have shredders, lifts. So be aware of these things. Okay, ask for assistance if you are uncertain. Follow the machine's operating instruction. Do not remove, tamper with machinery safeguards. Okay, this is again, I fix kar deta hun. I am the champion. Check machinery and equipment before you start up. Use lock and tag procedures when required. And this is very technical part. The lock and tag. More relevant to big machines, but anywhere where you're dealing with electricity, if you are trying to correct something, shut down the mains, shut down the thing, deplug the machine, and then start working, but and lock and tag the area where the machine can potentially start from. Okay? So these are simple rules that you need to follow. Never touch moving machinery parts. And believe me, despite telling people in the factory 100 times, we've had incidences. We've had people lose their thumbs, fingers, and we've had people who are demonstrating how the accident took place. Okay? So one accident took place where the guy cut his fingers off. Then the maintenance guy is going around and saying, this is how he was putting his hand in. And the maintenance guy's hand got cut. Yeah, this is a true incident. I'm not making these things up. Huh? This is a true incident. And we as management hold our head and say, ab kya kare? Because it's an H1 incident for us. And it goes as reported as a black mark or a red mark as far as MTR is concerned. So, very, very important. Never touch a moving machinery part. In the olden days, we used to have lifts in the jalas, no? That's, people used to put their hand in out there and try and do things. Thank God, now we have these automatic lifts. But again, don't try and put your hand in. If someone is missing the lift, let him miss it. Okay? Don't try and put your hand in and see what happens. Hopefully, the door will open. So try it. I mean, think about these things. Think about your actions before you do it. Sometimes we do it for the most, you know, what will you gain? One more person will come in the lift. He will not think bad about you. Usne janmuch ke darwaja band kar diya. That is not the objective. Huh? So think about your actions and think about the consequences of your actions before you act. Safe driving. Oh, we had to modify this a little bit from Orkla standards. We understand that safe driving will prevent injuries and serious incidences. Check your vehicle before you drive. How many of us check our vehicle? We just and go. Take road and weather conditions into account when you're driving. Just be aware of these things. Okay? And in the for the bikers, a bike does not help you get to from point A to point B faster. Okay? If you follow rules, it'll take the same time. And the objective of the bike is not to take you faster. Please. Then you'll cut through, make like, jump on the other side of the road and go. Please don't do those things. As long as you're working for us. After that, you want to do? Go ahead. It's your life. Okay? But even for India, I mean, if you forget about everything else and you look at your own personal responsibility towards your city and your country, if you follow the rules, your country will be a better place. Okay? We go and give abuses to our country and our politicians and our police and everyone else. We externalize everything that we do. But if you internalize everything that you do, this country will be a better place. If you all follow the rules, you all stop honking, it'll be just a better place. So think about these things. Fasten and secure any loose objects in your vehicles. Use seat belts in cars and other vehicles where required. Drive within speed limits. Stop, rest to stay alive. When you're going on a long ride, think about stopping. Okay? After 1-2 hours of driving, think about stopping, resting, and then taking the next step. Don't think that you are Superman and you can fly from one place to another in one shot. 5 hours, 8 hours of driving. Dangerous. You yourself will lose focus. Always use helmet while riding. And I have talked about this enough. I don't want to talk about it again. Stop or use hand-free mobiles, phones when driving. At least we should not even use hand-free mobiles. We should just stop somewhere and talk. I think, Bala, you need to take that out of the presentation. No hand-free mobiles when you're driving. Okay, do you think you can do multitasking? It's impossible. It's been scientifically proven that you cannot multitask. Your brain can only take one thing at a time. So don't think that you can multitask. I can ride, I can talk on the bike, I can, you know, do everything. Don't. You can't. Stop and stay alert, which already been said. Slow down. Someone is waiting for you at home. So forget about the company. Company will always wait for you to come back to office next day. But there's someone at home who's waiting for you. And please think about them. What if something was to happen? What do you think they are going to do? And for what? And for whose stupidity? Your own. So let's be very, very careful. This is one of our biggest challenges in India. Care for environment, which is we understand that our activities and products have an impact on the environment. Principles are do not waste resources such as raw material, energy, and water. You see electricity on, look at putting it off before you go home. You see water that we use, do not waste water. Even at your homes, even in office, everywhere, do not waste water. Okay? Reduce, reuse, recycle waste. Okay? Some great examples are of if one side of the paper is printed, the other side is always available for you to use. Then limit travels and use alternate communications for meeting. Today we have video, we have Skype and other things. We should try and reduce, because when we travel, we are using diesel. We may not personally do it, but the plane is using diesel. We are using cars when we reach to other places. So if we limit those travel, travel when it is necessary. Don't eliminate travel. We cannot eliminate travel. Travel when it is necessary. In other places, see how you can use alternative means of communication. Use appropriate dustbins for waste disposal, and we are going to be significantly upping the standards of this in the company. Do not put food waste, oil waste, waste cloth into the drain. We have sometimes a habit of washing our plates in the basins and everywhere. Remove the food out of it first before you start to wash them, okay? Because you are creating water pollution. Contribute to our ambitious environmental goals. We will be talking to you about these things very shortly before the end of the year. Okay, bring green ideas forward. So we are going to be doing a lot more in the environment space in the coming times. Okay, so these are the seven principles that we want you to be aware of. We commit to promoting as a company and as Orkla, we are committing to promote a safe and a healthy workplace and to care for environment. Okay, so this is something that as a company we will do. And as we are doing it, let me tell you one thing. I think we've been getting a feedback from some of y'all about the office practices. How many of y'all found your plastic water bottles missing today? Okay, including me. I came in and my bottle was okay. So from today, I think from November 1st, what we are planning to do is to eliminate plastics out of corporate office. Okay? This is a feedback we got. This is a feedback that we have got from some of y'all, and we have decided to take that action. So no more little bottles of water. They will not be there. We will give you alternates serving the same purpose, and we are systematically going to look at all places that where we use plastic, and we're going to eliminate all plastics out of our offices. And the same action will be done in the factory, but we still do produce about 1300 metric tons of plastic which is used in our products, which the CSR committee along with the management of the company are working towards to see what are the alternatives that we can use and how can we be more responsible towards the environment and towards our city and our country to ensure that we reduce the use of plastics in the company as a whole. So these are the commitments that we have decided to do. Let me hand you over to Bala. Okay, Bala will just take you through a quick activity that we want you to do, and then we can go back to our work. So over to you.
Thank you, sir. You can take this. soon. Yeah.
So good morning, friends. And having listened to Peter Ruzicka's speech and an interactive presentation by CEO, now this is the time for us to commit ourselves for EHS, whether it is at home or your work or wherever it is. And we have made a small arrangement that you have at the outside of this hall, you will be having a post-it pads. On that, you have to write what is EHS to you, okay, and what EHS means to you. So you just have to write and commit yourself and sign it and paste it on the acrylic board which is kept in front of you. And the slots are provided in that. Please paste it on the slots provided. So this is what I wanted to communicate. So kindly, one by one, you can start writing and then putting it onto the listing.
Good thing would be if you can give those pieces to everyone.
Yeah. Yeah, fine. Few examples also is displayed over there. You can even see that. What is EHS to me?